Hi, my name is Barlas. I'm with DataStax. I run the AWS relationship globally. And today we have Subodh, who is here from AWS. Subodh, can you just give us a little bit of background on yourself?
Sure. So I manage the partner solution architect team for AI, ML, and data and analytics for Americas.
You have a great relationship with AWS, and AWS is at the forefront of many things. Can you tell me maybe a challenge that you've seen with an AWS customer that was solved with possibly a Langflow or generative AI?
My own internal application that we have developed within AWS using Langflow, I wanted to mention that, which actually helps the sales teams. Because our information is scattered in, think about sales applications. Sales applications information is in Salesforce, that's one. Then you have information in about blog posts in URLs. Then you have application in terms of architecture documents, a ton of other wiki pages and documents. Summarizing that at point of sale becomes something very important.
Of course.
And that is, and writing such an application is difficult.
Yeah,
if I have to really write it through APIs, if somebody gave me a chart to say, okay, fine, for this, you go here, 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 and these are your conditions, and plumbing is already there, it becomes so easy. Huh? That is where Langflow actually—
And that's exactly what DataStax does. Why DataStax? Why DataStax and AWS specifically?
One of the areas which you probably, that has already started happening is small language model.
Mm-hmm.
Model that can fit on the edge.
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of data originates from devices. IoT devices, sensor devices, that and you have to interpret that to get an answer about how is this device doing? Is this the right device for this environment and so on and so forth? So speed of data and the speed of response is very important over there. Speed of data ingestion and speed of response. Here comes something that is right in the middle. For a language model to turn into a RAG, you need a very high-speed vectorization. If your data ingestion is very fast and response time needs to be very fast, something that DataStax was always known to be very good at, but this is having a high-speed, real-time vectorization of the data as it arrives is something that is extremely powerful to start giving real-time answers. That is something that very few vendors at this point have, but I think as people get tired of waiting for 3, 5, 8 seconds on a response, as the volume of requests increase, the latency requirement is going to shrink significantly. And people's desire in terms of having access to real-time data in their summarization is going to become very important.
Absolutely.
And for that, DataStax is very well positioned.